looking device against me. Get on with it, Jindosh. Though I'm not sure what you hope to accomplish. I must admit to feeling a bit of professional curiosity as to the function of the apparatus.
Patience, friend. Patience. The sequence of events is important. You'll come to understand my electroshock machine, but when? Before or after that light leaves your eyes? And where does it go when it disappears? Who will tell me that?
Has anyone ever loved the sound of his own voice as much as you do, Kieran? Perhaps the device could tell us that.
No, sadly, it cannot. But what it can do is take from you the thing you love the most. Your precious intellect. If you won't agree to collaborate on the next clockwork prototype, I'll use the device on that brain of yours, Sokolov.
I refuse. If I'm to be a drooling idiot, at least I won't be bothered by any more of your rambling theories.
Kieran Jindosh, Grand Inventor for Sokolos. He dreams of an army of mechanical soldiers. His invention, the Silvergraph. It combines mercury and a light on a plate. And an image appears. Some are delighted. Some terrified. He has a great mind for innovation, invention, progress, perhaps even greater than Sokolov. So young, when he attended the academy, so quiet then, they hardly noticed him, but he took it all in, understood, perhaps. Even better than they did. He works with Duke Luca Abel. They share overlapping interests, but only use one another. He's thinking the test subjects are all broken beyond repair. And it's time to obtain a fresh batch. At the academy, the other students and most of the teachers, they couldn't comprehend half of what he's telling them. Even 16. Such questions he asked as a child. Just free from the crib. Others grew to fear him. Just as he grew to love them. He waits for the breathing and the blood to stop. Then the brain. And the light. From their eyes. He loves that moment. When the eyes change. Finds it fascinating. He longs for an adversary worthy of his intellect. It is not vanity. There are a few who could match him. His mother asked, "Why did you do that to the cat?" Young Kieran only wanted to know what was inside. How it worked. Her distress puzzled him. Only Duke will let him have all the test subjects he wants. An endless supply. Almost arrested before the Duke found him. Carted off to some dank hole behind iron bars. For revolting crimes against his fellows, his experiments. Instead, the Duke gave him a title. It is important to him. He wants others to notice the complexity of his work, the genius of his innovations. These are his thoughts. So many years. He's imagined having his own teacher in a cage, like an insect under glass, begging to be released, admitting that his was the superior intelligence. I've already told you about this man.
The other lab machines are draining away too much electricity. Electroshock machine should work now.
No! 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 You don't know what you're doing! Anything! I'll give you anything you want! Stop! Don't do this! So much will be lost in Age of Advancement!
People like you can't be allowed to run amok.
And if I combine the acid against a copper plate, what does it do?
I knew that a moment ago. Does anyone know the answer?
I had an idea, but it's gone now. I'm very much afraid of what's happened. You can't have put me through that machine, but wait, what does it do?
Please, kill me. Please make me die.
Something glory you, something big is gone and I can't name it. Hello? I believe I've lost something very precious. Please help me find it.
The other students will laugh at me now.
Maybe there'll be apple pudding at dinner. I would like that.
His memories flee from him as he seeks them. All is shifting, intermingling. Great theorems drift just beneath the surface, just beyond his reach. But he cannot hold a thought for more than a few seconds. When he remembers, he is filled with rage and despair. The great cathedral of his mind, abandoned and in ruin. For just a second, he had a new line of thinking, the solution to a great engineering problem. Now, lost. In a way, he is more content now than he has ever been. He thinks of his dinner later, and hopes for cabbage with pork. You want me to point the way, help you onto a path. Now, let us be lost here together for a moment.
So many events in motion, each exerting subtle gravity. With Delilah, a new empire could be drawn, and all the old barriers broken. Much could be accomplished.
My clockwork soldiers have played their part, but each costs more coin than a wealthy man sees in a lifetime.
It could take years to find a solution on my own, but if Sokolov can be tamed, together we might refine the process, making new clockworks at a fraction of the cost. Whether I seduce my old teacher with the thrill of discovery, or whether I'm forced to apply the clamps to his flesh and turn on the voltage, no matter.
silver spoon. Stilton?
Pretty sure I took it with me.
I would have left by now. Storm.
This is amazing!
How many more chances will I get to travel? To leave Dunwall?
Just doing
he didn't
a job.
Want his teeth broken out. Maybe he shouldn't have opened his mouth.
Why would you work about such a thing?
We've been here for months, but we've barely seen a third of the house. If he can replace members of the Grand Guard with those blasted mechanical men, why not us?
Do you have to ask? Can you imagine one of them pouring tea? It might take your hand off.
Give Jindosh time. He'll figure that out too. We'll be out on the streets.
I wouldn't last a night outside, and neither would you.
No right to be here, stranger. Leave at once.
playback loop.
It would have to be you. Perhaps Megan came for you in Dunwall. But Jendosh,
he's alive, but I burned his mind out. Used one of his machines against him.
Well, that's the Corvo I remember.
Search is underway.
comes with it, too.
You did it. How is he?
Frail and wounded, but he'll recover.
I didn't think it was possible. You must have a story to tell. I'll hear it back at the ship.
All right, the